Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about Febuxostat. What is this drug Febuxostat? This is one of the anti-gout agent. We have another drugs within this category such as allopurinol, oxypurinol. These two drugs are structurally related to uric acid. So allopurinol and oxypurinol can produce few of the side effects by interfering with the enzymes involved in purine and pyrimidine synthesis. But Febuxostat is one of the drug which is structurally not related to uric acid. So it is not producing the side effects related to purine and pyrimidine synthesis. But this drug can produce some serious cardiac events in the patients. So Febuxostat is indicated for the hyperuricemia where allopurinol is not able to control the uric acid levels. In such conditions only Febuxostat is prescribed in order to eliminate serious cardiac events. So this drug is indicated for the gout which affects the joints of hand, even it can affect the joints of feet, resulting in the joint inflammation and pain. And this inflammation can also be expanded to the knee joints. In all these conditions, Febuxostat can reduce the uric acid levels, thereby can reduce the uric acid deposition within the joints. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of Febuxostat. You can identify that it is not having any structural relation to the uric acid. It is neither having purine or pyrimidine nucleus. It is having another heterocyclic ring system. So let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is a 1,3-thiazole with carboxylic acid at the 5th position. So we can write this as 1,3-thiazole-5-carboxylic acid. Now this ring is having a methyl group at the 4th position. So 4-methyl. Second position is having the phenyl ring. This phenyl ring is having a cyano group at the 3rd position, so 3-cyano. At the 4th position, it is having another side chain. Let us give the numbering to the side chain. So this is 1, 2, 3. So simply it is having the 2-methyl propoxyne. So 4th position, 2-methyl propoxy group is present. That is a complete name of Febuxostat. Now let us see how this drug acts. One of the important precursors for the uric acid is the hypoxanthine. This hypoxanthine is converted into xanthine where it undergoes oxidation by one of the enzyme xanthine oxidase. Then this xanthine is converted into uric acid by same enzyme xanthine oxidase. Now by increased action of xanthine oxidase, more uric acid is going to be synthesized which results in the formation of crystals. These crystals are somewhat dissolved. But undissolved crystals can produce a large crystals by crystal growth and they can be deposited within the joints. Now these monosodium urate crystals can be deposited within the joints so that they can stimulate the inflammation and activation of the neutrophils. All of these can produce inflammation of the joints resulting in the gouty arthritis. Now Febuxostat is one of the drugs which can block this xanthine oxidase enzyme so that it can inhibit its activity. And when this enzyme is inhibited, the uric acid synthesis and formation of crystals can be reduced. In this way, Febuxostat can reduce the formation of urate crystals by reducing the uric acid levels. So this is the structure of hypoxanthine. This hypoxanthine is converted to uric acid by two-step process mediated by xanthine oxidase enzyme. Here you can easily identify within the uric acid two oxo groups are present. So oxygen is going to be added by oxidation process. This is mediated by xanthine oxidase enzyme. Now Febuxostat is an inhibitor of this xanthine oxidase enzyme. When this enzyme is going to be inhibited, the uric acid synthesis and formation of crystals is inhibited. In this way, Febuxostat can reduce the uric acid levels, but this drug is limited in those patients who are not responding to allopurinol treatment. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of Febuxostat is that on use of this drug, the patient may have increased gout flares. This is because of decreased uric acid synthesis may result in the increased deposition of gout flares, particularly at the big toe, where the uric acid is released from the tissue deposits. That's why in order to control these gout flares, drugs such as NSAIDs or colchicine, they can be given to minimize the gout flares formed within the patients. Similarly, this drug can produce some liver failure. It can increase the liver enzymes such as ALT alanine transaminase and AST, aspartate transaminase levels may be increased up to 3 times. So when their levels are increased greater than 3 times, this drug should be carefully used. Another and very important precaution of this drug is that it can produce some cardiac events. So by use of this drug, patient may have increased palpitations, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, some severe chest pain, uncontrolled headache, dizziness, confusion, trouble in speech. All these symptoms may be observed by use of febuxostat. In such conditions, this drug should be carefully given as it produces cardiac damage, even death of the patient. What are the side effects? The important side effects of febuxostat mainly include nausea, arthralgia. Initially, it can increase the gout flares resulting in the arthralgia, and it can also produce some skin rashes, liver abnormalities, and tinnitus and vertigo can be observed with this drug. How it is given? This drug is available as tablets at different strengths such as 40 mg and 80 mg. Even it is also available at 120 mg. Initially, it is started at low dose such as 40 mg, given once daily. After 2 weeks of treatment, the dose can be increased up to 80 mg in order to reduce the uric acid levels. But in the patients with any renal impairment, this drug should be started at very low dose such as 40 mg. So that's about this drug febuxostat, which is an anti-gout agent, which is used in the patients who are not tolerated to the allopurinol, as this drug is free of side effects related with inhibition of purine and pyrimidine synthesis. And this drug can also increase the liver enzymes and can precipitate some sudden cardiac events. So that's about this drug febuxostat. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.